Today we are going to see about Indigo Revolt. So revolt, which means what? Revolution, which means oru purachi. Okay, so Indigo Revolt 1859 to 1860. The Bengal indigo cultivator strike was the most militant and widespread peasant uprisings. So uprisings. So uprising, what does it mean by uprising? Uprising mean some kalagam, elichi, okay? So the Bengal indigo cultivator strike was the most militant and widespread peasant uprising. The European indigo planters compelled the tenant farmers to grow indigo at terms highly disadvantageous to the farmers. The tenant farmer was forced to sell it cheap to the planter and accepted advances from the planter that benefited the latter. So there were also cases of kidnapping, looting, flogging and burning led by Digambar Biswas and Bishnu Sharan Biswas. The riots of Nadia district gave up indigo cultivation in September 1859. Factories were burned down and the revolt spread. To take the control of the situation, the government set up an indigo commission in 1860, whose recommendation formed part of the Act 6 of 1862. The indigo planters of Bengal, however, moved on to settle in Bihar and Uttar Pradesh. The newspaper Hindu Patriot brought to light the misery of the cultivators several times. So Dinabandhu Mitra wrote a drama, Nildarban, in Bengali, with a view to draw the attention of people and the government towards the misery of indigo cultivators. So the Bengal indigo cultivators. So the So in the indigo revolt, the Bengal peasants strike spread far and wide, turn into the peasants revolution. So Bengal peasants strike, that strike spread all over the India, and also that turn into the peasant revolution, that is indigo revolution. So European indigo gardeners, okay, so European indigo gardeners forced Indian farmers to grow indigo. எதுக்காக ஃபோர்ஸ் பண்ணுறாங்க? டு க்ரோ இண்டிகோ டு தர் பேனர்ஸ். ஸோ லீஸ்டு ஃபார்மர்ஸ் வேர் ஃபோர்ஸ்டு டு பே பேடி விச் தே ப்ரொடியூஸ்டு ஃபார் லெஸ் பிளே. ஸோ லீஸ்டு ஃபார்மர்ஸ் வேர் ஃபோர்ஸ்டு டு பே பேடி விச் தே ப்ரொடியூஸ்டு விச் தே ப்ரொடியூஸ்டு அவங்க ப்ரொடியூஸ் பண்ணுறது ஃபார் லெஸ் பிளே. ஸோ தே வேர் ஃபோர்ஸ்டு டு பை த லீஸ் இன் அட்வான்ஸ் ஸோ தட் தே குட் யூஸ் இட் லேட்டர். So also they were forced to buy the lease, so buy the lease cash in advance so that they could use it later, but that's not possible. Okay, so there were also incidents. So there were several incidents happened, so kidnapping, burning, looting, so on. So this uprising in the Nadia district. So that uprising headed by two people. One is Digambar Biswas, another one is Bishnu Sharan Biswas, was abandoned by the repression of European farmers. Repression of European farmers. So European factories were then burned down and uprising spread to other places. So after this uprising, European factories were burned down and the uprising spread to other places. So the government set up a own commission to bring the situation under the control in 1860. But so after the Indian farmers burning the European factories, the government set up a on commission, why? To bring the situation under the control. So part 6 of the law, so that is one law, that is part 6 of the law was created after recommendation of that commission. So in that recommendation that commission recommend one law, that law name is called part 6 of the law. Okay, so was created. So Bengal reasons, so Bengal peasants, so Bengal farmers going to settle in Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, for why? Because fear of repression by European workers. So Bengal peasants, Bengal farmers going to settle in UP and Bihar for fear of, for the scared of repression of European workers. So also, so there is one newspaper, that name is called Hindu Patriot. Okay, Hindu Patriot. That newspaper telegraph repeatedly about our farmers' life and also to light the plight of the cultivation. So that newspaper telegraph repeatedly about our farmers' difficulties of our farmers, of the cultivators. And also there is a one Dinabandhu Mitra that he wrote here one drama Nil Darban in Bengali with a view to draw that drama having the attention of the our farmers. So the government towards the misery of Indigo cultivators. Bapna revolt. Bapna peasant uprising was a resistance movement by the peasants against the oppression of the zamindars. It originated in Yusuf Shashi Paragana of Bapna in Bengal. It was led by Keshav Chandra Roy. The zamindars routinely collected money from the peasants by the illegal means of forced levy, abbats, enhanced rent, and so on. Peasants were often evicted from the land on the pretext of non-payment of rent. So the Bapna peasant uprising was a peasant movement. So that is a peasant movement only. Yeah, peasant movement against repression of landlords, repression of zamindars. So the Bapna uprising, the Bapna peasants uprising against, for that is a one process, that is a one movement, that is a one protesting, that protesting against for repression of landlords. Okay, so it's originated in Yusuf Shashi Paragana of Bapna in Bengal. And also landlords illegally collected taxes from farmers. So that landlords means what? Zamindargal. Okay, so that landlords illegally collected tax from farmers, and also they harassed them by demanding, why they harassed them? By demanding higher taxes, by demanding the higher taxes. Suppose if they would not pay the higher taxes, they evicted from the land. Yeah, they evicted from the land. So if they refused to do, so zamindars evicted the farmers from that land. So over the course of the day, all the farmers, so look at the second paragraph. Large crowds of peasants gathered and marched through villages, fighting the zamindars and appealing to other peasants to join with them. Funds were raised from the riots to meet the cost. The struggle gradually spread. So in the second paragraph, so landlords, we know that landlords illegally collected taxes and so many, they harassed them. So after that, so over the course of the day, all the farmers who were greatly affected by zamindars, yarala affected aanangalo zamindarala. So over the course of the day, all the farmers who were greatly affected by zamindars came together and went to the villages. So came together, okay, combined together, and they went to the some other villages and took other peasants to the local, and also invited them to join them in the fight against the zamindars. Okay, so fight against the zamindars, invited the, yeah, so these farmers went to the other villages, asked other villages to join them. So why join against the zamindars? So the funds is a very, very important for protesting. So the funds were raised from each and every farmers to control the cost of the protest. So this protest, this struggle spread all over the places, all over the places. So, and also in the ending, everywhere agricultural association were formed. So everywhere, so in our place, everywhere agricultural association were formed, whose main purpose, that main purpose of that agricultural association is against the law. So through this protest, the farmers brought people together. So in the protest, the farmers, the peasants brought the people together and also learnt how to fight peacefully. Yeah, that is called the revolt, Bapna revolt.